Now let's learn one important derivation for 5 marks. That is derivation of the expression of centripetal acceleration and hence centripetal force. Okay. What is meant by centripetal acceleration? See, when you take a stone and tie it with a string and start whirling, the stone keeps changing its direction continuously. So it is constantly accelerated because it is changing its direction. And this acceleration is acting along the radius of the circle. It is radial and it is towards the center. This acceleration is called as centripetal acceleration. The acceleration which is always along the radius and acting towards the center of the circular path in which the particle is describing uniform motion, circular motion, is called as centripetal acceleration. Now let's look at this diagram. Now consider a particle at a, like example of a stone tied to a string, and it has started whirling. Now the stone travels from A to B. Let it come to point B by taking t seconds time. To come from point A to B, the stone takes a time of t seconds. Now let us look into the velocity of the stone as it just started. Now the stone moved like this. That means it advanced along the x-axis. It also advanced along the y-axis. You can see that the stone has got two types of motion here. It is moving along x-axis. It is moving along y-axis also. All its velocity is taken horizontally. So the velocity of the stone or the velocity of the particle along AC is V, and at the starting point A, since it did not raise at the starting point, it started moving like this. It did not raise at the point A, so its velocity at A can be taken as zero. Now when it comes to point B, what happens? Now the point B, the velocity is acting tangential. At any point, the velocity, you know that velocity acts along the tangent. So this is not straight. This, as you had at AC. Now this velocity has to be resolved into horizontal and vertical components. Remember, in physics, whenever a force or velocity, any vector, acts obliquely like this, then you have to distribute the magnitude both horizontally and vertically. So resolving the velocity horizontally along BD, vertically along BE. What is the component of velocity horizontally? That is, parallel to AC is horizontal. This is BD. The velocity is distributed along horizontally with the magnitude BD. And BD is V cos theta. Horizontal component is cos theta and vertical component is sin theta. So BD is equal to V cos theta. And vertical component is AO, that is V sin theta. Now if theta is very small, remember, in mathematics, in trigonometry, if theta is very small, then the value of cos theta can be taken as 1, approximately 1, and sin theta as just the theta. So, approximating that theta is very small, for cos theta, I have to write 1. So, V cos theta becomes V into 1, that is V, and V sin theta becomes V into theta, that is just V theta. Now, let's take the change in velocities parallelly and later vertically. What is the change in velocity horizontally, that is parallel to AC? At the starting point A, velocity is V. At B, what is BD? What is the numerical value of BD? V. So what is the change in velocity parallel to AC? Change in velocity is denoted as delta V. Now it is BD minus AC. Now velocity along AC is V. Velocity along BD is also V. So V minus V. V minus V cancel out. Now change in velocity parallel to AO, it's vertically, is again change in velocity is delta V. Now if you look at that change velocity, it is BE minus AO. What is BE? BE is V theta. And what is AO? Velocity along AO is zero. So it is V theta minus zero. So it is just V theta. Okay, now we know that acceleration is rate of change of velocity, that is delta V by T. And what is delta V? We got delta V as V theta divided by T. that is V into omega, because you know that theta divided by T, angular displacement by time, is nothing but angular velocity. So V omega. So centripetal acceleration is V omega, or you can also write V omega as omega square R, because we know that V equals R omega. So substitute for V as R omega. So R omega into omega, that becomes R omega square. Or this omega square R can also be written as V square by R, using the relation V equals R omega, as I have shown here. So remember, the expression for the centripetal acceleration of a particle describing uniform circular motion is V omega, or omega square R, or V square by R. Now, this particle in circular motion is constantly acted by a force that's called as centripetal force, which acts towards the center of the circle. And you know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. So F is equal to M into, substitute for acceleration as V square by R. We get the standard expression for the centripetal force acting on a particle describing circular motion.